If you're watching this review with other people in the room, ask them to play a word association game with you right now. Say Cadillac and ask them what comes to mind. You can hit the pause button, we'll wait. Done? Did you get different answers? Yeah, that's what I thought.
Well, I mean, we're the fastest growing luxury brand in America right now. I think that's something that's interesting to people because, you know, they've thought a lot about Mercedes and BMW maybe, and, you know, you see a lot of people driving those cars, but we really are going through a renaissance.
Nick Twork is the head of Cadillac Communications, but Cadillac isn't just selling fast. Some of their cars, like the CTS-V, are really, really fast.
The Nürburgring in Germany is a place that many of the world's best car manufacturers use to develop their vehicles and refine them. But Cadillac, throughout the development of the CTS-V, used that particular track to refine this car. And in fact, the results have been stellar. We actually ended up with a car that was faster around the Nürburgring with the CTS-V than the BMW M5 or the Mercedes-AMG E63, its closest competitors.
This is the 2011 CTS Coupe that Real World Test Drive had for a week.
You know, everybody thinks this Cadillac CTS Coupe is really cool looking. The coolest thing I think is that there's no door handle, just a sensor inside. And then once you're in the car, to get out, you just push this button. But if you're worried about some type of computer malfunction or the battery dying, don't worry. It's got what I call the JetBlue flight attendant emergency switch. You pull this, the door opens. No slide comes out, but the door opens.
And if you wonder what happens if your battery dies when you're outside the car and you left your dog or your baby inside the car, you can use an actual key to open the trunk and use the emergency door release hidden in there. When I was little, a neighbor kid got into his family's Bricklin with his grandmother and kept opening and closing the gullwing doors until the battery died. Granny and the kid were stuck in there until someone got them out. I don't remember who or how. And if you're wondering why they didn't just use their cell phones to call for help, you probably don't know what a Bricklin was either, so never mind. The CTS Coupe has a hint of a tail fin on the trunk lid. It sort of reminds us of some of the glamorous Cadillacs of years past. But don't confuse glamour with land yacht. The CTS Coupe is not your uncle's Eldorado or your grandfather's Coupe de Ville.
Why is this different from the two-door Cadillacs I remember from the 70s or 80s?
Well, it's a much sportier car to drive. I think that's the best way to say it. It's obviously, it has the same kind of design appeal that those cars had in their era in a modern sense, but this is really a driver-oriented car in terms of, you know, the performance it offers.
But in part, to show you how much times have changed, the CTS V Coupe that we're standing in front of right now with Nick has a manual 6-speed transmission. When was the last time you heard of a Cadillac with a stick? Were you in the FDR administration? But the CTS Coupe is also, of course, available with an automatic.
What about a convertible version?
We do not presently have a convertible version of the CTS planned. At some point in the future, obviously convertibles are a big part of the luxury market, and we are keeping our eye on that space, but we have no announcements to make at this time about that.
One thing I will say about this Cadillac CTS is it's definitely a showstopper.
I was driving the CTS Coupe to Home Depot and a bunch of college-age guys gave me a thumbs up as they drove by in their BMW 3 Series, as did an older man who was probably young the last time Cadillac was cool.
Well, I mean, this car has really cross-generational appeal. For us, you know, it's about attracting more educated, more affluent consumers to the brand. And whether you're young or old, a beautiful car is a beautiful car. And, you know, people seem to react very favorably to the CTS-V Coupe.
The 3.6-liter six-cylinder engine generates 304 horsepower and a 0-60 time in the low sixes. But the CTS-V version must mean vroom vroom. Remember, this is a Cadillac we're talking about.
The thing that makes this car unique, it's not only a very, very fast car, it's also very fun to drive and also comfortable and quiet, so it really has the best of both worlds.
They have some type of magnetic ride thing that combines metal shavings with oil or something in the shocks and somehow makes the car both responsive and smooth.
I think the most interesting technology on the car is something we call magnetic ride control. It's a special damping system for the wheels and shocks that uses a fluid with iron particles suspended inside it. And we can instantly vary the response of that shock to give you that combination of ride and handling that you could get no other way. So that's really a signature technology and I think one of the cooler features in the car.
Here's something I've never heard of before, and it costs $110. It's called the Underhood Appearance Package. I think it's this cool engine cover with the Cadillac crest on it, but I don't know how often you lift the hood to show your friends what you have under there. OnStar is standard and they can look stuff up for you and remotely program your navigation screen, which is very convenient and safe when you're driving and really want to pay attention to the road instead of doing something stupid with your smartphone.
For the purist, the Cadillac CTS Coupe comes standard with rear-wheel drive, front-engine layout, but it's also available with all-wheel drive, which is what I would get. Especially because I live where it snows a lot. On a hill.
For some reason, the Performance CTS V-Series is not available with all-wheel drive. Something else not available on any of the CTS Coupes is a blind spot detection system or a seeing eye dog to help you change lanes. Aside from the mirrors and the Linda Blair thing, I just use the blink and pray method. Other Cadillacs have blind spot detection, but for some reason the CTS Coupe doesn't. The Cadillac CTS Coupe Premium Collection starts at about $47,000. It gets 18 miles per gallon in the city and 27 on the highway. The 19-inch summer tire performance package adds more than $2,000. That brings the price as tested to about $50,000. I'm Grant Winter, reporting.